to our second lesson of the day. My name is Nicholas Okuthe. We want to proceed with what we are looking at. We are looking at different types of radioactive decay. We have already looked at alpha decay, and we have learned that in alpha decay, it is represented by helium atom. And in that case, the atomic number decreases by 4 and mass number decreases by 2. We want to look at the second part of decay called beta decay. Beta decay is represented by an electron. That is, the atomic number is 0, the mass number is negative 1. And it is denoted by a symbol beta. So what happens during beta decay? During beta decay, the mass number remains the same, while the atomic number increases by 1. That one can represent in a decay equation like this. We take an atom X whose mass number is Z, and atomic mass number is A and atomic number is Z. So if it undergoes beta decay to emit an atom Y, then the mass number remains A, atomic number will increase by 1, so it will be Z plus 1 plus the beta particle. So in this case, X is the parent nuclide, while Y is the daughter nuclide. The particle emitted there is beta. So just as what we have learned, the atomic number of the parent should be equal to the sum of the atomic number of the daughter plus the atomic number of the emitted particle. The same applies to the mass number. The mass number of the parent should be equal to the sum of the mass number of the daughter plus mass number of the emitted particle. Then we finally look at gamma radiation. In this case, sometimes we call it gamma decay, but we use radiation because in this case, no particle is emitted. We only emit energy in form of gamma radiation. So it is denoted by a symbol gamma. Gamma is a Greek letter written like that, almost looking like capital Y, but not. So it is represented by gamma. And during gamma decay, energy is emitted but with no new isotope. Meaning, if it is atom X, then after a gamma decay, it will still remain atom X plus that energy in form of gamma radiation. So mass number remains the same, atomic numbers also remain the same. So the particle remains the same. No new isotope, no new atom is formed. So with all this, we want to look at examples. My first three examples is on alpha decay, then the next three are on beta decay. We are not going to look something on gamma radiation because it is just as simple as that, nothing changes. So I want to look at example on alpha decay. We take example of uranium-238. We normally use the number uranium-238 to denote that is an isotope, meaning it has the same atomic number but different mass numbers. So the mass number for the one we are referring to is number 238. Decays by emitting alpha particle to become thorium. So if we want to write the decay equation, uranium is the parent. So uranium-238, we are given the atom there, mass number is 238, atomic number is 92. So it decays, so we put an arrow and we put an alpha particle on top to show that we are emitting alpha particle to become thorium. Thorium is number 90, mass number 234. Then it emits alpha particle, it is particle and not particle, so it is only one. And indeed, if you look at this case, 238 here will be equal to 234 plus 4. So the mass number of the parent, which is 238, is equal to the mass number of the daughter, 234, plus mass number of the particle emitted 4 here. So 234 plus 4 gives us 238. The same to the atomic numbers. 92 will be equal to 90 plus 2. So with that information, we can now do question 2. Thorium-230. The atom is given there, undergoes decay to become radon 222. Find the number of alpha particles. So meaning not one, not two, there may be more than one emitted. So to do this, we first write the decay equation. So we take thorium 230, that 90, undergoes alpha decay, we don't know how many they are, to emit radon 222, number 86, plus alpha particles. So alpha particle represented by helium, but it's not one, so that means we could represent it with one letter N. So if you want to find the number of alpha particles emitted, which is actually N here, then we can use the atomic numbers or we use the mass numbers. If we use the mass number, then I'll be taking the mass number of the parent, which is 230, is equal to mass number of the daughter 222 plus mass number of the particles. So I take N times 4, which is 4N. If you simplify that, then you find out that 4N is equal to 8 and N will be 2. So it means there will be 2 alpha particles emitted in the process. There will be 2 alpha particles emitted in the process. We can as well do that using the atomic numbers. You take 90 is equal to 86 plus 2 times N. We'll still get N to be 2. That means that 2 alpha particles will be emitted. So you could try this in your exercise book. We have number 3, example 3. Uranium 234, the atom is there, 234-92. Decays to polonium. Polonium is 218-84. The atomic number is 84. Mass number is 218 PO. By emitting alpha particles. Particles, meaning there are more than one. Represent this in a decay equation. Hence, find the number of alpha particles emitted. Maybe I could do for you the decay equation. The parent is uranium 234. Mass number is 92. Decays by emitting alpha particles. I write the symbol alpha there. To polonium 218, number 84, plus N alpha particles He 42. So you could do this and work out the value of N just the way we have done it here. You can use the atomic numbers, or you can use the mass numbers of both the daughter and the parent particles. We look at the next examples on beta decay. That is example number 4. Radioactive sodium. Sodium can also be radioactive, meaning it can undergo radiation, radioactive decay. So radioactive sodium undergoes beta decay to become magnesium. Sodium is number 11 in the periodic table, and its mass number is 23. So 11, 23 there. It decays, it produces beta. Then it produces plus an atom, an electron there, which is the particle produced during the decay, beta decay. So you can see there, the mass number 23 of sodium is equal to the mass number of magnesium 22 plus 0. So this should be 23. Yeah. Then, so we correct this. It should be like that. Then, the same will apply this 22. 23 is equal to 22 plus negative 1. There's a problem here. Yeah, so the mass number 23 of sodium is equal to atomic number of magnesium 22 plus 0. While the atomic number here, 11, is equal to 12 plus negative 1. So you have seen the atomic number has increased by 1, while the mass number has remained the same. Look at number 5. Lead 214 decays to polonium 214 by emitting beta particles. Calculate the number of beta particles emitted. So this also what we do. We take lead 214, yeah, then atomic number is 82. It undergoes beta decay to become polonium 214, 84 plus alpha, beta particles 0, like that. So they could be n of them. So if you want the value of n, then you just do the same way we have done it for the example in number 2 there. So we can equate the mass numbers, 214 is equal to 14 plus n times 0, which will not give us the value of n. But if we take 82, using the atomic numbers, is equal to 84 plus n times negative 1, which is negative n. So you get n to be 2. So it means 2 beta particles will be emitted. So we could also try this elsewhere. Number 6, uranium-238 undergoes decay to become lead-206. Find the number of alpha and beta particles. So in this case, we are emitting both alpha and beta particles. Maybe before you do it, let me just present it in a decay equation. 238, 92 undergoes decay. So it undergoes both alpha and beta to produce lead 82206 plus alpha, which is helium. We don't know how many are they, so we can represent it with 11x plus beta. We don't know how many they are, so we can represent it by y. Then we solve for x and y simultaneously. Thank you, and that's the end of our lesson.